Hello Cubers, now I have completed the sanding of the of all the molded pieces. As you can see here, all the pieces have been sanded down to their final size and shape. You can see all the pieces are basically completed, and I have sorted them according to the to their position on the puzzle. Also I have this bunch of puzzle parts that are the internal pieces of the puzzle, and here you can see the amount of dust created by this process. It is quite a large amount of dust, which is basically plastic and milliput. I am not going to throw this dust away. I will try to put it in this container. It's a good thing to have some plastic or epoxy dust at your disposal. You never know when you are going to need it to fill some holes or anyway, it's better to have it and don't need it rather than need it and not having it. This is the dust generated by the puzzle I'm building at the moment, the 4x5x6. Anyway, I think that now that the puzzles are completed, the puzzle pieces are completed, the next step is to spray paint them in black color. But before doing that, because I will give them a good wash, just to remove any dust that has been. You can see that the puzzle pieces are a bit dusty. Also, I will wash these internal pieces because of the sanding process. All those pieces have been dusted, and this is what I'm going to do now. I will wash all those pieces basically just with water, no need to use any soap or anything. Now that all the pieces have been dried from the washing, all the water is left. I will replace them on these containers, just to keep them separated. And I will prepare them for spray painting. What I'm basically going to do is to, for example, this piece here, I will only need to spray paint these surfaces, and basically not the internal part of the piece. So I will use masking tape to cover all those parts of the piece I don't need to be painted. As you can see, I have left only the parts that has been modded. If you spray paint this part of the piece, it will interfere, because there will be some amount of paint laid up onto the piece. This paint will interfere with the turning of the puzzle. For example, you see in this piece here, I want to cover this part of the piece so that no paint will go onto there and make the puzzle turn badly. It's not a difficult step, the one I'm doing now. Just need to be a bit careful to cover up the correct surfaces of the pieces. Now, as you can see, I have some pieces, for example, this one here, that hasn't been modded at all. I will not spray paint this puzzle piece, so all those pieces that haven't been modded will be like this one, again, will be left aside. Now that all those pieces have been, let's say, protected from masking tape, I will glue them on this wooden board, and I will try to put them facing like that. I will not just leave them there. I will try to place them in an upright position, so that to be able to spray paint all the sides, around the puzzle piece. In order to do that, I will use this small hot glue gun, which is ideal for this kind of job. I need to leave it a bit too warm. Now that the hot glue gun has been heated up, I will glue all those pieces onto this wooden board. Try to keep a small gap between those pieces here to allow the spray paint to go on all the sides of the pieces. I find that hot glue is the best way to do this. It is fast, it is easy to unglue it after it dries, you just break it apart. And the pieces are glued onto the wooden board firmly enough not to fall over. Now, because I have masked the pieces with masking tape, the heat from the hot glue doesn't damage the plastic at all. Also, even if I haven't placed any masking tape, the heat is not that great to damage the plastic. This is high quality plastic and doesn't have a problem with such amounts of heat. Basically, this is it. I will continue the same process for all the puzzle pieces, and I will speed the video up and come back to you after I'm done. Now that all the pieces have been glued up onto the boards, the spray paints I will use, first of all, is this one here, which is intended for graffiti artists. It is a thick spray. The paint is pretty thick and covers some of the small imperfections, let's say, from left on the puzzle pieces. I will apply one coat of this spray. Then I am using this spray paint here, which is a black color glossy finish, which is more how can I say it, more thin and liquid. So it I use this mostly for the sides of the pieces. This leaves a better finish. And after that, I will apply a clear varnish like this one here, which basically just protects the black color I have painted the puzzle pieces with, so that the color doesn't come off when using the puzzle. Of course, always when I spray paint pieces, I do this outside and try to not inhale any of the paint, although those paints are non-toxic ones, it is better to be careful. Now you can see here that the puzzle is completely finished. You can see it is I have assembled it, and the final step is to apply the stickers. Now I usually order ready-made stickers from Oliver's sticker shop. He offers great service. I just design the the template, and he sends me back the stickers according to the template I have sent him. Now, basically, nothing difficult. What I'm going to do is to apply the stickers onto the puzzle. This one here is the white face. I'm gonna start with this face first. I'm using this knife. Take out the sticker and apply it very carefully onto the puzzle. These stickers, I apply first the stickers on the puzzle pieces that have not been modded in any way, and after that I always heat treat the stickers with just a light pass of the flame, just to make the bond to make the stickers stick to the puzzle much better. This method works extremely well, and I will proceed now with the stickers onto the modded puzzle pieces. And because you can see, I don't know how good you can see, but the puzzle has let's say rough surface, which is made intentionally. I like that feeling. It is made by the spray paint. The first coat of spray paint I used leaves this rough surface on the puzzles, on the pieces, and this makes the stickers not stick very well to the piece. But after this light pass with my lighter, the stickers adhere to the pieces perfectly. Oh, this is the white face, all stickered up. You can see here in this close-up. Because this puzzle is all square and doesn't have any curved faces, it is pretty easy to design and sticker those stickers. Basically they are all rectangular pieces. Anyway, this is the process of stickering the puzzle. I will continue with the rest of the faces, and after the puzzle is finished I will demonstrate. So that's it, this is the, I have completed the stickering the puzzle, and here you can see it from up close. This is the completely finished puzzle after a lot of time and a lot of work. This puzzle is, has finished and is ready for scrambling and going for a lot of hours. It turned out very beautifully, a very nice puzzle and a very difficult one. Most of you probably already know that these floppy eye cubes extremes are very difficult puzzles. So I hope you like the puzzle. I hope you like the videos of the modding process. This is the puzzle. Bye.